too many people here today. Yeah, and top it off, I'm having an allergy attack, so I've got a spot on my face that's going to probably swell up like a balloon. No, is that what it is? I don't know. Usually it's something I eat.
There's one on this port. Yeah, it's on.
Well, if it gets too big, I won't be able to do the concert.
Oh. Oh.
I might have to be down on the ground.
Can you sit on a chair? Can you pull up a chair and sit on the chair? And then, or does that put you up too high? Well, we can, yeah, I can do announcements off to the side, and you can pull up the chair that I usually sit in, and then we'll just put it back. Okay, that's fine. Danny has to go home. Good morning. Grace and peace to you in the name of Christ our Lord. This morning in our coming together, in our gathering, we want to be reminded of some announcements. You've seen things on the screens, but want to add to those that outside the doors here, outside the office, you will see little stars on the window, and those are little things that asking from Bible school. So if you can, sometimes, it's a variety of things, but if you'll stop there and you'll find something that you'll be able to take a star or two and donate for Bible school. Also this week, on a Tuesday following this week, we'll be wrapping boxes for Bible school. So if you can, from the hours between 8 and 1, if you can come in and wrap some boxes, that would be great as we prepare for Bible school. This afternoon, there is a Buchanan Choral Society is doing a concert at Wesley Chapel, and they're encouraging people to park at the Performing Arts Center, and then we'll have a shuttle bus, actually our church van, that will take folks then over in order to have an easier access to Wesley Chapel. Also this afternoon, the Celebration of Life service for Sylvester Green will be occurring at 3 o'clock. There's a visitation up until that time, and the service begins at 3. As you probably saw in the paper, Sylvester was John Green's grandfather. So our prayers for John and Holly, their family, and all of the extended family as well. In our bulletin, you will note that we have scheduled, or it says, Rotary on Tuesday, but there's no Rotary on the fifth Tuesdays, and this Tuesday is one of those. But do note that the outdoor movie, in terms of Rogue One, will be shown hopefully outside. Hopefully by the time Saturday comes, all the rain will have passed. But that will be our first outdoor movie. Oh, thank you. Yes, yes. Sylvester Green is a brother to Patty Brake. And I know she was here for Sunday school, but then was going to go over and be with family. Thank you, Alvin. So the outdoor movie, you see that in your bulletin. We do have another announcement just as a way to get us ready for Bible school. So take it away, Bible school folks.
Okay, just as a disclaimer, I would like to say that there is nothing that I would not do to get kids into Sunday school and to church and Bible school. So here we go. Hello, everybody, and I am Captain Shield, and I'm getting powered up for Vacation Bible School. I'm here to invite you, every one of you, thank you, to join us here for Vacation Bible School. At Hero Central, we're all heroes, and everyone knows that heroes have sidekicks. So let's welcome our sidekick, Flame. Well, hello, everybody. Hello, Flame. Can everybody help me say hello to Flame?
Hello, Flame.
Hey, Flame, how you doing?
Thank you. I sort of feel that strong hero welcome.
Flame comes from the heart of the bamboo forest to serve at VBS in the heart of Hero Central Headquarters. At VBS Hero Central, we will share the awesome assignment of training terrific heroes.
Does this training have anything to do with amazing tasks and superpowers?
Well, that depends on what you're thinking of as superpowers. We'll meet biblical heroes and discover qualities that make them true heroes in God. Plus, there will be epic adventures such as wonderful Bible stories, great music, cool crafts, exciting science, fun games, and more.
Sounds super. I want to be one of God's heroes, and tell me more.
Well, do good, seek peace, and go after it. That is our hero verse from the Bible. During each session, we will discover ways to be God's heroes by living out this superhero verse.
Wow! Definitely sign up me up for this here epic superhero adventure.
Well, why don't you all plan to join us at our VBS Central Hero Central? You know, it runs from June 11th through June the 15th and starts at 6 p.m. and ends at 8:30. The pool party is going to be June 16th at the Buchanan Upshur High School pool and is a covered dish, and it is from 6 p.m. until 8. Registration for VBS is going on now. It is online at 2017.cokesburyvbs.com/chapelhillum, or you can register next week in person.
Whoa, Captain Shield. I got to get out of here. Got to power up for VBS Hero Central. Heroes, see you there.
See you later, Sidekick Flame. And I will see you at VBS Central Hero Central. Do good, seek peace, and go after it.
As Diane said, we do all kinds of things for the kids, right? So let's stand and greet one another in the name of the Lord.
Thank you.
morning in our gathering song. Our gathering song is Amazing Grace, My Chains Are Gone. The words we'll find on the screens. Wondrous God, we come in the beginning of our worship together to proclaim and to shout out our love for you. We have received that amazing grace We know the chains that have been broken in our lives, and you have set us free that we might worship and praise and glorify your holy name. Lord God, this is why we're here. And in your name we pray. Amen.
Join me in the call to worship. God, we believe you have called us to unity, but often we have isolated ourselves from others.
God, forgive us for the times we have turned our backs on those who are different.
God, we believe you have called us to live together as one body.
God, forgive us for the times we have created division within your worldwide church.
God, we believe you ask us to look, listen, and learn from others.
God, forgive us for the times we have ridiculed and attacked those with different viewpoints.
God, we believe you ask us to accept and seek to understand all who are called by your name.
Forgive us for the times we have offended you by failing to love others as we do ourselves.
God, we believe you call us to be one even as you are one.
Forgive us the disunity we have harbored and make us one.
Number 176, Majesty. In prayer. God, renew our minds and rekindle your love in our hearts, so that by the power of the Spirit we might find the oneness that you intend for us. God, may we see in your oneness our need for unity. God, may we see in your threeness our need for community. God, may we see in your creativity our need for diversity. God, may we see in yourself our need to love each other. Amen. You may be seated.
As you note in your bulletin, today we honor all members of the U.S. military that paid the ultimate price for our freedom. There have been over 500,000 fatalities since the start of World War II, which has been during the lifetime of many members of our congregation. They gave their lives for us, so today we wish to honor them over this Memorial Day weekend. May God bless them, their family, their friends, and others that they loved. In honor of members of the U.S. Army and the Army National Guard that gave their lives for our freedom, we light this candle. In honor of the members of the U.S. Navy that gave their lives for our freedom, we light this candle. In honor of the members of the U.S. Marine Corps that gave their lives for our freedom, we light this candle. In honor of the members of the U.S. Coast Guard that gave their lives for our freedom, we light this candle. In honor of the members of the U.S. Air Force that gave their lives for our freedom, we light this candle. You have in your bulletin an insert that lists the number of deaths that have occurred since World War II. I hope that you keep that peace with you, especially tomorrow, as we share with the whole nation Memorial Day.
Our New Testament reading today is from Acts, right at the beginning. The traditional author of Acts is Luke, who also wrote the Gospel of Luke. So at the beginning, when he says the first book, he is referring back to Luke. In the first book, Theophilus, I wrote about all that Jesus did and taught from the beginning until the day when he was taken up to heaven after giving instructions through the Holy Spirit to the apostles whom he had chosen. After his suffering, he presented himself alive to them by many convincing proofs, appearing to them during 40 days and speaking about the kingdom of God. While staying with them, he ordered them not to leave Jerusalem, but to wait there for the promise of the Father. This, he said, is what you have heard from me. For John baptized with water, but you will be baptized with the Holy Spirit not many days from now. So when they had come together, they asked him, Lord, is this the time when you will restore the kingdom to Israel? And he replied, it is not for you to know the times or periods that the Father has set by his own authority, but you will receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you, and you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem, in all Judea and Samaria, and to the ends of the earth. When he had said this, as they were watching, he was lifted up, and a cloud took him out of their sight. While he was going and they were gazing toward heaven, suddenly two men in white robes stood by them. They said, Men of Galilee, why do you stand looking up toward heaven? This Jesus who has been taken up from you into heaven will come in the same way as you saw him go into heaven. Word of God for the people of God.
Would the children join me in the front, please?
I have decided to follow Jesus. thank you for sharing your money with the pig. Now, do any of
your parents or grandparents have pictures? You can go ahead and keep that money in the pig, okay? Do any of you have pictures when you were a little baby? Have you ever seen that picture when you were a little baby? Does it look like you? Probably not the way that you are now, huh? Well, this was something that I made for my mom and dad at their 50th wedding anniversary. It's called a shadow box. And it has the kind of the story of my family. Now, in these pictures, things that you see.
A fire truck in
there. Yeah, there's a fire truck in there, isn't there?
And a car.
And a car, yeah. My brother was big on cars, yeah. And a pig, yeah. My other brother grew pigs. And what? And trees and apples. That's because my dad had an apple farm and a peach farm. What else do you see in there? The vegetables. Always had a garden.
And
a basket full of vegetables, huh? And a church, huh? And a barn. Oh, just lots of things in there, wasn't there? Lots of things. Yeah, football. My brother played football. Red apples and seashells. Wow, isn't that cool?
Milk,
yes, we had cows. And a bucket of milk, huh? So all kinds of things. Yeah, well, that's a cow, isn't it? Not a fishy. That's a cow. Flowers, yeah. Okay. And people. Now, in those people that you see, do you see me? Can you find me? Where am I? Nope, that's my mom. Nope, that's Rachel when she was little. Can you find me? Nope, that's Philip when he was little. Nope, not yet. You haven't found me. No, I'm not a fire truck or a dog. No, that's when my brother and his wife got married. Mm-hmm. Yep, that's the car. Look at this old picture up here in this corner. That's me. Can you believe that right there? See that? See that picture? That was when I was in the first grade. And my cousins... And that's me again when I got married. Do you see my hair? I always thought that was the worst picture ever. My cousins did my hair before the picture, and they gave me horns. You see that? So, but what? Yeah, you couldn't find me at all because I've changed. And you have changed since you were a baby. And in all of our changing, God is always present. And so in another year, you'll be different than you are right now because God changes us and God's love is with us. So how... Oh, okay. So... Yep, it is. So... All of our changes that we go through, God is always present, okay? And we are loved. We are loved very much. So will you pray with me? Okay, well, you still can put it in the pig. Okay, let's pray. Dear God, we thank you for all the changes that come to our lives. We thank you for being with us and... being the light that we might follow. Lord God, bless us. Continually we pray. Amen. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. That the church say amen.
Amen. Amen.
This morning, ask that you stand with me for the reading of the gospel lesson. It comes to us from the Gospel of Luke. It says John in our bulletin, but it's actually the Gospel of Luke, chapter 24, verses 44 through 53. This occurs as one of those post-resurrection appearances of Jesus. He has been with the disciples, and they've had fish together. Then Jesus said to them, "These are my words that I spoke to you while I was still with you. For everything written about me in the law of Moses, the prophets, and the Psalms must be fulfilled." Then he opened their minds to understand the scriptures, and he said to them, "Thus it is written that the Messiah is to suffer and to rise from the dead on the third day, and that repentance and forgiveness of sins is to be proclaimed in his name to all the nations, beginning with Jerusalem. You are witnesses of these things, and see, I am sending upon you what my Father promised. So stay here in the city until you have been clothed with power from on high." Then he led them out as far as Bethany, and lifting up his hands, he blessed them. And while he was blessing them, he withdrew from them and was carried up into heaven, and they worshiped him, and they returned to Jerusalem with great joy, and they were continually in the temple blessing God. The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. You may be seated. And let us pray. And now, O Lord, we just ask that your Holy Spirit will come and touch our hearts as we hear the words of your scripture. May your word be a lamp unto our feet and a light unto our path. Amen. These accounts of Jesus, especially those that are the mysterious kind, like the account. Today is Ascension Sunday. It's the day in which we hear this narrative of Jesus having this final departure with the disciples. We hear that his garments became glistening white and that Jesus just kind of disappeared in their midst. They had been in Jerusalem, and then Jesus walks with them to Bethany. Bethany is about 3 miles. And so I can imagine that in that time of walking, it must have gone through Jesus' mind and heart in terms of what are the words? What are the words that I leave with them? And so we hear then, when they reach Bethany, he turns to them and blesses them and begins to tell them that there will be a power that's going to come, a power of spirit from which they will share in Jerusalem, but go beyond to all nations. And this power will enable them to share the good news. And so in that moment in time, Jesus kind of disappeared. And so this morning, in recalling the scripture text, we must also recall the mystery. And some folks don't like to live in the mystery, but I embrace it. The mystery of the way, how did this body, resurrected body of Jesus, become so flesh and blood that he could eat broiled fish with his disciples after his death and resurrection? How does this this embodied body of Jesus, how does it then become changed yet again? And what I hear within the scripture text is this theme of change. When Jesus was with the disciples for 3 years, they developed a relationship, a rapport. And you could tell that in John, when it is recorded that wonderful prayer that Jesus has with the disciples when they're together in the upper room, John records that as a prayer of Jesus sharing with those he loves so very much, asking God to watch over them when he knows that he will be departing from them because of the crucifixion, that impending death. And so the relationship that he has with them changes. It changes from that 3 years they then experienced his death and his rising. And the relationship with Jesus changed in those moments as well. And so within the scripture text, as we come to it, this mystery of ascension, this mystery of the way in which Jesus goes back to sit on the right hand of God, and the promise of the Spirit is given. There's change. Several weeks ago, I had the opportunity to ride with my 23-year-old son. I said opportunity. But anyway, he likes his music, and of course he likes it very loud. But then he found a piece that was clean, so that was the one I got to listen to. Here in a while, we'll listen to it together. But it was a song that kept reiterating the word changing. Changing. And so that song stuck in my head as I heard again the scripture text, not only from Luke, but also the second volume of his writing that we have in Acts, as he tells about that ascension of Jesus. That mysterious moment in which he went back to God, and in his place brings the Holy Spirit to life for the disciples. Changing. And so with the children this morning, we talked a little about changing. They remembering what their baby pictures look like. I must really look different from my first grade picture. They couldn't find me. Changing. We do change. And I know that there are times in our lives, especially in the life of the church, when we talk about changing things up and doing one thing versus another. And some of us just don't like change. And we say it loud, I don't like to change. But friends, we are changing every moment of every day. We're changing. I mean, have you looked at your dust in your house? That's you. That's you laying there on your entertainment center and on your coffee table. Those are skin cells there, you know? We change. We change. And in the change that occurs for us, in through all of the changes that come our way, and some of them are very hard, God is always there for us. God is there. God is the foundation. God is the fortress. God is the rock upon which we stand in our lives. And so all of this change that goes on, we're part in this circle of life of change. But the steady beat, the rhythm of our heart, the intake and the exhale of our breath are gifts to us from God. Yes, change happens. And yes, God is a part of all of that. And God will never leave us forsaken. If we feel in one of those moments of transition and change in our lives that we're in this all by ourselves, friends, we're not. We're not. Whether we're experiencing the death of a spouse or the addiction of a child or whatever it is that's going on, we are not in it by ourselves. That's why we gather as church family. That's why we tell our joys and concerns to each other, because we lean upon one another. And that's why we know, we are assured that God is present with us. Thanks be to God. Amen. 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 Let us pray. Oh, holy God, speak to our hearts. Bring the changes into our lives that help us to reflect the people you see that we can be. Work us, oh God, like clay to mold and make us anew. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. In this response to the word, just want you to hear that song that my 23-year-old played. To hear it, the words are printed on the insert in your bulletin if you need the words to kind of follow along. If you are in a moment of change in your own life, if you sense God working you through that change, just know the altar is a place of prayer where we can come and find strength. Let us listen together.
I am not done changing, out on the run, changing. I may be old and I may be young, but I am not done. Someone changing, we had some fun changing. Sometimes I wonder if she'll be the one when I'm done changing. Some of us stopped running, some of us went home, some of us don't got one, so we'll behind the fences, looking at me strange, wondering when I'm gonna come to my senses, but I'm still changing, I can't change my way. Changing reminds me of my changing.
Do we have a word of joy or concern that we can share this day? Bob sharing that he and Adele Sue are celebrating their 44th anniversary. Here comes the microphone. Oh, Justin, you want, go ahead.
Yeah, I'm not sure if this is a joy or a concern, but my daughter and my father-in-law left this 7 o'clock this morning to go to Florida for 12 days. It should be interesting.
I've had some changes in my life this week, in the last 2 weeks, actually. Carl's grandson graduated from University High, and he will be going into the ROTC program at WVU and joining the Air Force. And my grandson, William, graduated from Elkins High School Friday night, and with quite a few honors, and he was dubbed as the golden child by his two brothers, and he is a golden child to me, as all of them are. But, and then also on Tuesday, I have a joy and a concern. My oldest grandson, Corey, who is a senior at WVU, will be donating stem cells. And 3 years ago, he signed up on a registry, and he got an email just in the past few weeks that they found a match for him, and she's a German lady, Bonnie, and she's 69 years old. And I am so proud of him, but I'm very, very concerned. And so Tuesday morning, he will go to Pittsburgh and do that. And, oh, I forgot to mention that my grandson, Will, is going into nursing at WVU, Judy, and be a nurse anesthetist, and I told him he could at least be something I could pronounce. So a lot of pride here, and my parents, the great-grandparents, got to go to that graduation, and it's a very memorable time for me.
Thank you, Barbara.
And I have a guest today, too. My cousin Nancy's here from Ohio with me.
Good. Welcome, Nancy.
On behalf of the band, we want to thank everybody for all their help, and we couldn't do it without everybody's help, but we raised $2,925 selling hot dogs that we'll be able to bless other people with. So thank you very much.
Thank you. Okay, Bonnie, why don't you just come up here?
Well, I have a joy, too. My granddaughter graduated from fifth grade, and I had to go to Morgantown on Friday. And then on last week, I spent 6 days with my Chinese family and my granddaughter, Dora, who got the lovely quilt that I displayed. Was married, and the Chinese really do a big celebration. It's all about money, and there was a lot of gold flowing around. It was very, very entertaining, and well, it was wonderful. And then 2 days later, we went to Johns Hopkins, where Dora got her master's degree. So it was a very big, eventful 6 days.
I have a joy in that year after year, when Risa and I have put out the call for help for Vacation Bible School, you guys have always stepped forward to help us out and to make it a very successful Vacation Bible School. As what Diane has said, whatever we need to do for the kids, right? So this is my concern, though, this year we still have some openings that we need help in. So if you could please look at your calendars and see if you have some free time for that week or the week before for decorating. There's a schedule in your bulletin today. And then also just prayers, always prayers, that this is very successful for the kids in the community to come. So thank you.
Do we have any unspoken need? Just want to raise a hand and let us pray. For your grace and mercy, O God, that leads us through all the changes of our lives, we thank you. We thank you for your presence that sustains us through those changes. Lord God, we come and we continue to hear the concerns that we share as well as that we have in our community. Where we are battling an illness, Lord, just enable us to be victor through your grace. When we are challenged, Lord, enable us to stand firm as your people. And as we have shared just the prayers of our hearts, with a lifted hand, we ask, O God, that you hear those prayers of the hearts. Prayers for ourselves and our families, for our community, and Lord, prayers for our world. You are the Almighty God. And yet, O God, you bend down to us like you did the children of Israel, and you fed them and us. You are most powerful, but yet we know your hand as your hand wipes away a tear from our eyes. We thank you, Lord, that when we come together, you are certainly present in our midst, so that together we can pray as Jesus taught his disciples. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Earlier asked for prayers for John and Holly and all of the Green family. But we also have church folks who are having procedures this week. Ask that you keep Roy Law in your prayers, that you hold Patty Brake in your prayers this week as well. And now as we come to where we can share with God and with one another those precious gifts that he has given to us, let us share. Thank you. And, O God, we do come and give you thanks. We thank you for those who were willing to die for their country. We thank you that we can gather with family and friends and remember. We thank you that we can join together and lift up and share a song of praise. We thank you, Lord, for these gifts and for the gift of life, ever-changing that it is. You are our constant. Amen. I'll fly away. We see the words on the screen. Let's sing together. Some glad morning when this life is o'er, I'll fly away
to a home on the celestial shore.
Now let us go. Let us go in the grace and mercy of God to lead us forth and be our God as we are his people, changing, but sharing the good news. Amen. Amen. Amen.